Hey there, welcome to English with King Ife. So today I'd like to discuss something really important, and this discussion is addressed towards school administrators. Now, I noticed a trend with school administrators, some school administrators, not all, wanting their teachers, especially their English teachers, to acquire the British accent. And when they say acquire the British accent, they are usually focusing on getting that rhythmic pattern of the accent. And I've always, said this in all of my training and also in most of my previous videos. I've always said this, that the importance of speaking clearly, or the importance of having an accent, or the importance of just speaking a language, is just for you to communicate effectively. Communicate effectively. And to for you to communicate effectively, all you need is to acquire the right pronunciation techniques. Just know how to pronounce English sounds, and know, the stress pattern, the proper stress pattern for words, and know something about emphatic stress. If you've been able to cover all these three, then I don't think you'll have any problem at all. Whatever you say, people will definitely understand you. So you don't necessarily need to acquire any kind of rhythm that is typical of Cockney accent or the London accent or any of those things. So I'll always tell people to try and listen more to BBC news. You listen to BBC a TV station or the radio station as well. If you don't have access to the radio, you can download Radio Garden app. The Radio Garden app contains all the radio stations of the world, and once you get there, you can search BBC World Service, right? BBC World Service, and try as much as possible to listen to them often. And from listening to them often, you realize that they use a more minimalistic rhythm when they speak. You don't hear that typical rhythm you hear from many diction teachers in Nigeria. And that rhythm often requires them to have a high-pitched voice. But if you listen to BBC News, you realize that you can have like a minimal, your breathing can actually be minimal and you'll sound more eloquent, and you're going to be a whole lot clearer, right? So that should be the focus of a lot of us. We should not really focus our minds on trying to acquire a British accent. And I also plead with the diction teachers, I beg your pardon, with the administrators, stop trying to get your educators to have a more British accent. It's not something that can easily be acquired. I mean, the rhythm can't be easily acquired, but the pronunciation corrections they can take it. Your pupils, as students, all they need to communicate effectively are correct pronunciation and correct stress pattern, and that's all. So try as much as possible to teach that and allow the kids to express their own emotions when they speak. So it's going to really help them. Right, it's going to help them find their own individuality in the English language, because I don't like it when I hear kids sound alike, or kids are trained to speak more like robots. They begin to sound like robots. You come to the class to greet them and they're all saying good morning in the exact same way, or saying how are you in the exact same pitch of voice. No, that does not make any sense to me. So I believe that we should try as much as possible. And diction teachers as well should take note of these things. Don't try to get the students to have a particular rhythm. Teach them pronunciation, teach them proper stress pattern, teach them how to use emphatic stress, and don't try to get them to have any particular rhythm, because there are several rhythms. If you travel to the UK, you realize that different cities have different rhythms to their spoken English. If you travel to the US, you realize that different cities have different rhythms to their spoken English as well. So try as much as possible to use a more de-accented dialect of the English language and the de-accented dialect of the British English accent is the BBC English. The BBC English, or people call it the received pronunciation. The received pronunciation doesn't, you don't have to, stress yourself trying to imitate or mimic any particular rhythm, okay? And for the American accent, you use the general American, which is what you mostly hear on CNN. So I think with this, I've been able to convince you that accent is not really the most important thing, or rather rhythm, the rhythm of an accent is not really the important thing you should pay attention to. And of course, you should know that most persons who have this British rhythm in their voice, or the American rhythm, pronunciation rhythm in their voice, sometimes they tend to mispronounce words. And you may not know because you're more or less listening to the rhythm rather than listening to the pronunciation. And sometimes you don't even know the correct pronunciation of these words. So, or you say, oh, this person has a speaks with a British accent, but the pronunciation is flawed when we listen to them. So try as much as possible to focus your attention on correct pronunciation. And that's why I will always, always love Chimamanda Ngozi Adichie, because she's the quintessence of clear speech. Yes, when you listen to her, you will understand her 100%. And anybody around the world, everybody around the world who speaks the English language, they all understand her as well. So that should be what all of us should strive to achieve. Clarity is what we need, and not anything that has to do with having any particular British rhythm, American rhythm, Cockney rhythm, or all of those things. Keep that at bay. Look at what is most important, and that is clarity in communication. I'm King Ife, and I more than anything love to see you prosper. Have a lovely day.